Hello, my dear students. Hope the earlier videos were useful to you. Now we will move forward to our next topic, that is story of transport. That means transport. We will mainly discuss about transport. But before we begin about transport, students, suppose you want to travel from Dhubri to Guwahati. So you will require what? You will need to go there by bus, or by car, or by train, yes? So from here, we come to the definition of transport. So, to carry goods or people from one place to another is called transport. So transport is what? This bus, car, train, all these are transport. Transport can be public transport, private transport. Public means bus, trains, all these are public transport. And private transport means your own car or whatever like that is known as transport. So transport means, the definition of transport is to carry people and goods from one place to another is called transport. Now, during ancient times, the ancient people, what they used to do? So during ancient times, people did not have any sufficient modes of transport, right? There were no bus, train or car like that. So during ancient times, people used to move on foot or animals such as horsebacks, camelbacks, etc. like that to travel and also for carrying heavy goods. Now, ancient people also used boats for to travel, like to travel for in water, such as water, river, like that. So ancient people also used boats made of simple wooden logs to travel along water routes such as river, water, like that. But later on, what happened? Later on, there were some developments. Developments like people learned to join together planks of wood to make boats having streamlined shape. Okay. Now, after that, what happened? After that, wheels were invented. Wheels, you understand? Wheels? Yes, wheels which are used in bus, car, all that use what? Wheels. So, after that, wheels were invented, which made a great change. Yes, it has made a great change. Such as, wheels were used in making the transport vehicles. Transport vehicles means what? Car, bus, all this. Like bullock, in earlier days, bullock carts, horse carts and camel carts, etc. use these wheels. Now, the invention of wheels also led to the development of bicycle, which is a popular mode of transport nowadays. Yes, you students also use bicycle for to go to here and there, like you come to school also by bicycle, right? So in a bicycle also there are wheels. Now, after all this, in the beginning of the 19th century, it led to the invention of steam engine. Steam engine is also called external combustion engine. Which led to the development of trains or ships. Trains for what? It is a mode of transport on land. Yes, trains cannot go, cannot run on water. So, it is a mode of transport on land. And ships. Ships were the mode of transport in water. So, steam engine were developed in the beginning of the 19th century. And in the second half of the 19th century, the internal combustion engine was invented, which led to the development of automobiles. Automobiles, do you understand? Automobiles means car, bus, truck, etc. All these are called automobiles. These were used to travel on land, and there were internal combustion engine were also used in motorized boats and ships to travel in river or water. So, in the second half of the 19th century, what was invented? Internal combustion engine, which led to the development of automobiles. Automobiles means car, bus, trucks, etc. And these were used to travel in land. And in water or in a river, they were also used, like in boats, ships. All these internal combustion engine were used. All right. Now, during the early 20th century, it led to the development of aeroplanes and helicopters as a means of traveling by air. Yes, aeroplanes and helicopters, they are means of travel or means of transport in air. Then electric trains, monorails, supersonic aeroplanes and spacecrafts are some of the modes of transport during this 20th century. This is all about story of transport. Okay, students, see in your book, the invention of steam engine led to the development of new modes of transport. See, trains, ships, steam engines were used. Steam engine means which used coal as fuel for making steam, which used coal. Okay, and during the second half of the 19th century, internal combustion engine. Internal combustion engine means they don't use coal, they use what? Petrol, diesel, fuel. Okay, petrol, diesel as fuel they use to run automobiles. As we have discussed, to run automobiles they use all these things. Automobiles means car, buses, trucks, etc. Now in the early 20th century, what happened? Aeroplanes, helicopters come in use. See, aeroplane provide us a very first mode of transport by air. Yes, things were developing. So this is all about the story of transport. Now since we have discussed about story of transport, that means transport. Transport means what? To carry goods or people from one place to another. From one place to another means what? From one point to another point. Yes, from there we come to know about what? Yes, our next topic. We will discuss about our next topic, that is distance. Distances. See students, here there are two points, point A and point B. But there is a space between these two points, point A and B. Yes, there is a space. We can say there is a space and the space has a length. Yes, so that means the length of the space between two points. And what does that mean? The length of the space between two points is called distance. Simple. Distance means the length of the space between two points. For example, the length of space between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. That means what? So that means distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. So distance means length. Distance means length. That means distance and length are of the same types. Yes. See here, as the definition speaks, the length of the space between two points is called distance. So distance and length are of the same type of things. So when we say measurement of distance, we actually mean what? We actually mean measurement of length. Yes. See, here the example says length of space between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. So 200 kilometers is what? Length of space between Delhi and Agra. So the distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. So whenever we use or whenever we say measurement of distances, we actually mean measurement of length. From where? We will discuss about measurement. So measurement is what? It is the, what is the meaning of measurement? Measurement means it is a process of comparing an object with a standard unit of measurement. See, it is a process of comparing an object with a standard unit of measurement. For example, if you go to a tailor, whenever you go to a tailor to stitch your school uniform, he or she takes your measurement. Yes, he or she takes your measurement by using a measuring tape. You have observed, I think, right? So that is what That is a standard unit of measurement, that measuring tape. It is a standard unit of measurement. So, what? He is doing what? He is doing measurement. So, that process of comparing an object. Comparing an object means the object is you and he is comparing you with a what? Standard unit of measurement. Standard unit of measurement means what? Here, measuring tape is the standard unit of measurement. So, this is all about measurement. So, from here, we need what? So, measurement requires what? So, measurement, for measurement, we need what? For measurement, we need some standard unit of measurement, like meter. For measurement, we need some standard unit of measurement, like meter. But, what is standard unit of measurement? Yes. In our daily life, we can use a variety of objects such as hand span, forearm length or footsteps to measure the length of an object. Yes, sometimes we use all these type of things, right? But are these units same for all the persons? That means, I mean to say, are these unit means, that is the length of forearm or the length of footstep, are these same for all the persons? No. Obviously not. Hand span, forearm length and footstep are different for different persons. So, we need something which does not change from person to person or place to place. From here, we come to know about the need of standard unit of measurement. Yes, from here, we come to know about the need of standard unit of measurement. That means a unit of measurement which has a fixed value, which does not change from person to person or place to place. It is simply called a standard unit of measurement. For example, we have discussed what? Meter. Yes. Meter is what? It means the same length for everyone. Let us suppose 1 meter. 1 meter means what? I know the same thing 1 meter and you also know the same thing 1 meter. That means what? It is the same length for everyone. Now, let us suppose, for example, the length of a table is 2 meter. Here 2 is what? 2 is the magnitude of length. Yes, 2 is the magnitude. Magnitude means value. Value of length of the table. And meter is what? It is the unit of measurement. But if we say that the length of the table is 2, does it make any sense? No, it does not make any sense. That means measurement is not complete unless both the numbers and the unit are mentioned. Yes, if you say the length of the table is 2, it does not make any type of sense. So, from here we come to know that every measurement consists of a number and a unit. Yes, every measurement consists of a number and a unit. Number is known as the what? Magnitude. And unit is the measurement of the unit. Now, we will know about SI unit. SI unit means to have a uniformity. Uniformity, you understand? Same thing. Same value. To have a uniformity in the measurement of various physical quantities. Physical quantities means length, mass, time, all these are physical quantities. The scientists have adopted international system of unit, which are called SI unit. SI unit, the full form of SI unit is System International D Units. See, System International D Units. The SI unit of measuring length is what? Meter, which is in short form it is written as M. But sometimes in our daily life, students, we use the word kilometer, centimeter, millimeters also, right? So, this kilo, centi, milli are the prefixes, are known as the prefix. Prefix which are used before the SI unit. Kilo, centi, milli, or these are all these are known as the prefix. Prefix which are used before the SI units. SI unit means what? Meter. Yes. As we are discussing about measurement of length, that is measurement of distance, we will discuss about meter here, okay? Now, kilo, centi, milli means what? These are prefixes which are used before the SI units. Now, kilo means what? Kilo means what? Kilo means 1000. 1000. That means 1 kilometer means 1000 meter. नेक्स्ट कम टू सेंटीमीटर. सेंटी मीन्स 1/100 और 1/100, 1/100, दैट इज 1 मीटर इक्वल्स टू 100 सेंटीमीटर और 1 सेंटीमीटर इक्वल्स टू 1/100 ऑफ मीटर. नाउ द थर्ड वन इज मिलीमीटर और मिली. मिली मीन्स 1000 और 1/1000, दैट इज 1 मीटर इक्वल्स टू 1000 मिलीमीटर और 1 मिलीमीटर इक्वल्स टू 1/1000 मीटर. नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ लेंथ. सिंस मीटर इज यूज अ स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट फॉर मेजरिंग द लेंथ ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट, बट सेंटीमीटर, किलोमीटर, मिलीमीटर, ऑल दिस आर ऑल्सो यूज समटाइम्स, राइट? बट वाई ऑल दिस आर ऑल्सो यूज? बिकॉज द टाइप ऑफ यूनिट यूज डिपेंड ऑन द मैग्नीट्यूड. मैग्नीट्यूड मीन्स, येस वी नो, वैल्यू डिपेंड्स ऑन द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द लेंथ टू बी मेजर्ड. दैट इज द यूज ऑफ प्रॉपर यूनिट ऑफ लेंथ. प्रॉपर यूनिट ऑफ लेंथ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्टूडेंट्स, मीटर कैन बी यूज टू मेजर द लेंथ ऑफ टेबल, हाइट ऑफ बिल्डिंग और अ ट्री, यस? बट वॉट अबाउट द लेंथ ऑफ अ पेंसिल और द थिकनेस ऑफ अ कॉइन और अ थीन वायर और डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू विलेजेस और टू सिटीज? वॉट अबाउट दिस? We know meter can be used to measure the length of a table, height of a building or a tree. But what about all these things? That is the length of a pencil or the thickness of a coin or a thin wire. Our answer is, since the length of a pencil is small, it cannot be expressed in meter. Yes, it is very small, right? Length of a pencil is small. So the length of a small object is measured in centimeter or cm. Again, the thickness of a coin. What about the thickness of a coin? Or a thin wire, which is very small, even smaller than a centimeter? So this type of very small type of lengths are expressed in millimeter or mm. Okay, now what about the distance between two villages or two cities? The distance between two villages or two cities is very large. So these type of bigger distances or bigger or larger distances are measured in kilometer or km, which is expressed in km. Yes. From here, we need what? Length measuring devices. Yes, we need some measuring devices, right? So the length measuring devices are, first type is meter scale or rulers. Meter scale, when we use, if the object is straight, then a meter scale is used. For example, length of a table, it is what? It is a straight thing, so we use a meter scale. But again, if the object is round or curved, then we use the second type, that is meter scale. If the object is round or curved, then a measuring tape or sorry yes then we use a measuring tape. If the object is round or curved, then a measuring tape is used, because a measuring tape can be bent around the round object. Yes, for example, round object means the width of a tree or measurement of a chest or waist. Can we use a meter scale or a scale or a ruler? No, we cannot use. For that type of thing, we use measuring tape. Yes, measuring tape can be used for measuring straight objects also, as well as round objects also. See students, these are two types of measuring tapes. See, this is a measuring tape. This is also a measuring tape. Now, in your book, it is mentioned how to measure the length of an object. It is mentioned here. And there are some precautions to be taken while using a scale. Now, students, come to the last topic, that is to measure the length of a curved line. Curved line means a wavy line, is also known as a curved line. We cannot measure that curved line by using a scale directly, right? So for measuring that curved line, we need what? We require a thread or a scale. See, the length of a curved line can be measured by using a thread and a scale. This is how it is measured. This is all about our chapter.